So far, our fastest lap is a 1:15.7. Thank you.
as all the cars are now over the line, your top three again are a Red Bull, Hamilton, and Nico Rosberg. Thank you for joining us for free practice today. We'll be back with more Formula One action very shortly.
How are you? I'm just passing on your qualifying goals for this weekend.
Good afternoon, and we hope you're ready for an exciting qualifying session as the teams make their final preparations here in Canada. When it comes to getting lap time out of this circuit, it's traditionally been about maximizing top speed. Do you simply remove as much downforce as possible, hang on into the corners and max out down the straights?
Top speed is a key factor for this circuit. Even if you can achieve the same lap time as someone running less wing than you, chances are you'll find overtaking difficult if you have too much drag.
Let's go.
best lap so far is a 1:14.7.
So qualifying is complete and we're all set for an exciting race tomorrow. Your top three are a Red Bull, Vettel and Max Verstappen. The grid is set then, so that just leaves the race itself. Join us tomorrow where we'll be live with all the action. And until then, it's goodbye.
How are you? I have some information on the race goals you should keep in mind.
There is, as I look out of my commentary box window, a very large and very excited crowd here today, eagerly anticipating another Button came from last place to win here in 2011, and there's certainly no shortage of drama on offer here at the Canadian Grand Prix. If you want flat-out racing, you've come to the right place this weekend, as it's full throttle for 59% of this 2.7-mile circuit, peaking at around 210 miles per hour going into the final chicane. But that speed requires discipline, and there are more than a few close walls here just waiting to punish drivers with a heavy right foot. It's a favourite for fans and drivers alike then here in Canada. We're used to seeing the unexpected happen here, and with me today to enjoy it all is Anthony Davidson, a man who knows firsthand the surprises that can pop up in this race.
I do indeed. I had a good chance of some points here in 2007, but unfortunately it wasn't meant to be. My old colleague Takuma Sato, though, he managed to finish sixth, so the team took home three valuable points, and that was a big boost to everyone at the time. I'm not sure I can think of anywhere else that so consistently provides the kind of late race excitement we get here. Obviously, towards the end of the Grand Prix, the brakes are getting worn, maybe the weather situation has changed, so there's a lot to keep fighting for all the way up to that final corner.
You've done well to put it on pole, but we've still got work to do. Try to cover the inside line off the start.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. It's Red Bull in pole position then, with Sebastian Vettel starting alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Rosberg, Lewis Hamilton, and Raikkonen, Gutierrez, Sainz, Bottas, and Felipe Massa, Kvyat, Perez, Romain Grosjean, and Wehrlein, Hülkenberg, Alonso, Jenson Button, and Marcus Ericsson, Harry Anto, and Nasser, Kevin Magnussen, and Jolyon Palmer rounds off the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Thank you.
A great win then for the Red Bull team today. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
Well, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean, we could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres, but at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed over everyone else, and that's exactly what they had today.
And as the adrenaline dies down after another eventful Grand Prix, here come the top three, out onto the podium. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. A strong race then for our championship leader. That's extended their advantage at the top of the standings. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
Fernando Alonso. Wherever he is, whatever team he's in, when is he not just brilliant? He'll give you a performance every time, just like he's done today.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.